Anyhow, it's President's Day today, by the way. It's and as such, I wanted to bring in Professor Harvey Kay, professor of democracy and justice studies at the University of Wisconsin at Green Bay, author of numerous books, the latest, The Fight for the Four Freedoms, What Made FDR and the Greatest Generation Truly Great. His website, twitter.com/HarveyJKay, J-K-A-Y-E. Hey, Harvey.
Tom, good to hear your voice.
Back at you, Professor.
On the phone as opposed to on the air alone.
There you go. You said you want you have a story for us about Newt Gingrich, the National Mall, and the presidential monuments.
Yeah, it's just a segue into presidents. About 10 years ago, my younger daughter was interning for Senator Russ Feingold at the U.S. Senate, and she called and said that she had just come from a lecture that all the interns were encouraged to attend by Newt Gingrich. And Gingrich had told them all that he had walked the mall some evening in D.C., obviously, and said that he discovered the presence of God on the mall, that, you know, that America was this, you know, godly nation. And I said to my daughter, well, that's fascinating. We can all see the mall as we wish, but I don't quite know what to say. But I kept thinking about it. And then, if I could just show, a few years later, he brought out this little book. I don't know if it's on the air there or in your studio.
Yeah, it's God in America.
God in America, yeah. And it's basically a walking tour of the national monuments. And I have to tell you that I'm always amazed by how conservatives can lay claim to both history, you know, time and space, which isn't really theirs. So you know, I had been thinking for quite some time about when I walked the national monuments ever since I was a child. In fact, what I find there is this sort of democratic narrative, but a narrative that I'm not so sure that we all think about when we go to the mall. So I wanted to say that on President's Day, I know today's not a good day to go walking around anywhere in much of the country, but when people go to Washington, they really ought to think about the National Mall in terms of being this grand narrative of American life and just how progressive the narrative is down there on the mall. You've got the Revolutionary General, you've got the author of the Declaration of Independence, you have the president who led us through a civil war and signed the Emancipation Proclamation, and you've got the president who creates with, you know, millions of Americans the New Deal and then goes off and fights fascism in World War II. And then, of course, you know, additionally, Martin Luther King and other monuments. I mean, it's just truly a narrative of democratic struggle and, in fact, democratic progress for all of the tragedies and ironies in American life. And I'd like people to think about that on President's Day and you know, think about just the kind of history that we progressives have to assert in favor of a more progressive future.
I'm curious. I've been reading Henry Wallace's works on the air now for a few weeks.
Uh-huh.
For a few years, actually, but I mean pretty aggressively, yeah, the last few weeks. Particularly his article, April 9th, 44, in the New York Times, where the Times editorial board asked him if there were fascists in America, who they were and what we needed to do about them. And he basically said that the fascists in America were the ones who were reaching out for control over government because they already controlled the marketplace. He went back to FDR's economic royalist meme.
Mm.
And I've been arguing on the air that the word fascist is not a reasonable word for Americans to use to describe these guys, because everybody thinks of Nazis when you say that, and it just distracts,
yeah,
from the argument. People have suggested neo-fascists. There's FDR's economic royalists. In my book, The Crash of 2016, I used economic royalists fairly heavily. Do you see any new terms? I mean, robber barons is the old one. What's emerging? What do we call these guys?
Well, I know that a lot of folks have been calling them plutocrats.
Oh, plutocrats, right? Is a good one.
I mean, I like that one a lot. I love the economic royalist reference because that conjures up this sort of American radical tradition that goes back to the Revolution.
Right.
So I like that a great deal. The plutocrats, of course, conjures up the image of the, you know, the fat cats of the Gilded Age, as they would say. So, mostly because I'm a fan of Franklin Roosevelt and love the American Revolution so much, I like economic royalists, but plutocrats has a kind of punch to it, if you think.
Well, you're a professor of democracy studies. What would you call... I'm asserting here that modern-day conservatives are not really conservatives, because conservatives are in favor of small incremental change in society, and these people are calling for a radical reconstruction of society. Now, granted, it's a radical re- or deconstruction of a fairly radical forward construction that happened back in the 1930s,
yeah,
and 40s and 50s, but still, I'm suggesting that they're radicals. Would you correct me? submitted that as a paper to your class?
Well, I would talk to you, Tom. I say, you know, Tom, I like the spirit in which you're writing this, but I hate the fact that we now use the term radical, which is a great democratic concept, to refer to folks on the right. And I regret the fact that somewhere along the way we lost the term reactionaries.
That's the word. Yes.
You know, so that would be. I wouldn't downgrade you a bit. In fact, I'd praise you for your inventiveness. But I should be using
the word reactionary rather than the word radical.
Yeah. Although, in fact, you know, the fact that you get the Kochs, as you were just saying on air, who are saying, well, you know, we're not really reactionaries. You know, we support gay marriage and so on and so forth. We want to destroy labor unions and cut government down tremendously in size. And of course, maybe Rand Paul would like to think about that, and maybe they would like to promote his campaign.
Yeah. Well, there's this freak show going on on the Republican side that is, I think, increasingly not being taken seriously by Americans, unlike 4 years ago. But
yeah,
reactionary.
Yeah. So we went from the circus of 4 years ago to the freak show of today, right?
It really is sad. And, you know, these recycled wannabes who have no chance and they're outside the mainstream, and yet they're getting, you know, the Huckabees and the...
Yeah,
right. Incredible. Professor Harvey Kay, Professor of Democracy and Justice Studies. You want to read one of the very best books on the founding of America, read Harvey Kay's book, Thomas Paine and the Promise of America. His most recent book, The Fight for the Four Freedoms, What Made FDR and the Greatest Generation Truly Great. Harvey, thanks for dropping by.
Thank you, Tom.